Hello students, I welcome you to the online English class. I hope that you're fine and doing well in your studies. Today I am going to teach you the next chapter, which is titled as Deep Water. So dear students, first of all let me give you the brief introduction of the chapter. Thereafter I'll talk about its further details. So as far as the chapter Deep Water is concerned, this is basically an autobiographical account of the writer, William Douglas. This is basically an excerpt from the book which is written by William Douglas, that is titled as Of Men and Mountains. So this excerpt has been taken from the same book. It highlights how William Douglas as a young boy was almost nearly drowned in the water. And thereafter, how it affected his future life, and it also throws light on how he got success in overcoming from the fear of water. Okay, so now let us talk about the author, William O. Douglas. He was graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in English and Economics. After working as a teacher for 2 years, he took up as a career in law. He is the longest serving justice in the history of the law. Okay students, now let us talk about the plot of the chapter. So Deep Water, as I already told you, it's an excerpt taken from Of Men and Mountains, is written by William O. Douglas. It highlights how as a young boy he was nearly drowned in a swimming pool, and he recalls his fear of swimming following an incident in which he had been swept by a huge wave. Okay, now another incident which further aggravated his fear was when a bully pushed him into the deeper side of the swimming pool, and he was nearly drowned, but slowly and steadily he overcame his fear through determination and strong will. So dear students, this part highlights that fear can be the strongest obstacle in one's progress. So if you have a strong desire, if you have a zeal and enthusiasm to overcome from the fear, definitely you will start blowing trumpet over all the difficulties, and you will definitely attain height in your life. This is only and only because of overcoming from fear. Okay dear students, he even took the services of an instructor. He also swam in different rivers, lakes and seas to overcome his fear. The title also signifies that the author's fear was deep rooted. That's why this excerpt has been given such a title, because it highlights that his fear was really and certainly deep rooted. The most important aspect of the chapter is its theme. Let me talk about its theme. So one can completely conquer one's fear if one understands the truth contained in the words of Roosevelt. What are those words? All we have to fear is the fear itself, and all our terrors and fears are psychological. We only need to be determined and courageous enough to get face to face with our fear. William Douglas was able to overcome his fear of water only by becoming a competent swimmer. So my dear students, what you require is the strong will and enthusiasm. That's what happened with the writer. So had he not been so enthusiastic, had he not been so determined, definitely he would not have got success. His efforts would have been very futile and, you know, all in vain. So it is his determination, it is his zeal that made him so successful in overcoming the fear of water.